Hello friend, welcome back. In this video, I will take you a deep dive into what exactly is Laravel and the reason why Laravel remaining the leading PHP framework even today. So let's discuss about Laravel features. First of all, it's MVC support and object-oriented approach. The first and best advantage of using Laravel framework is that it flows model, view and controller-based architectural pattern, and it has an expensive, beautiful syntax which makes it object-oriented. Then built-in authentication and authorization. Laravel provides an out-of-the-box configuration for the authentication and authorization system. That is, in just a few artisan commands, your application will be equipped with secure authentication and authorization. Then packaging system. A packaging system deals with the multiple support software or libraries that help the web applications to automate the process. Laravel uses Composer as a dependency manager, which manages all the information needs to multiple packages. Packages are a great way to accelerate development is to provide the functionality we need out of the box. Then multiple file system. Laravel also has a built-in support for the cloud storage system such as Amazon S3 and Rackspace cloud storage, and of course for local storage. It's amazingly simple to switch between this storage option as the API remains the same for each system. One can use these three systems into one application to serve file from multiple locations like in a distributed environment. Then artisan console. Laravel has its own command line interface called as artisan. Common uses of artisan include publishing package asset, managing database migration, setting and generating boilerplate code for new controller, models, and migration. These features freeze to development the creating proper code skeletons. Then eloquent ORM. The eloquent ORM is Laravel built-in ORM implementation. Laravel has the best object relation mapper as compared to the others framework out there. This object-oriented mapper allows you to interact with your database object and database relationship using expressive syntax. Then template engine. Laravel comes with the inbuilt template engine known as the Blade template engine. Blade templating engine combines one or more templates with a data model to produce resulting views. Doing that by transferring the templates into cached PHP code for improved performance. And then testing. When it comes to the testing of the application, Laravel by default providing the unit test for the application, which itself contains tests that detect and prevent regression in the framework. Integration of PHP units such as testing framework is very easy in Laravel application. They have so many features in Laravel. I have highlighted some of the features with you. Hello friend, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how can update your localhost PHP version. Because I will work in our localhost, and for the reasons right now, I am using the Xampp. And Xampp is the free open source localhost server, and you get that software from the Google. It's totally free. So first of all, you have to download that software, and then it's very much simple process to install it. Just click on the next, and automatically there should be installed in your computer. And after installing it, you get this type of one of the pop-up. And first of all, you have to run your Apache and the MySQL. So here I just first of all I start the Apache, and then I just start the MySQL. And when two of these will start, then you can access the localhost. Like here, you have to write down as a localhost. And when you click on the localhost, it should be redirected to the localhost and the Xampp. And into the localhost Xampp, if you go to the PHP info, and right now there is, you can see that is actually PHP version 5.4. So right now I am using that PHP version. But if you go to the Laravel official website, like here, there is actually the laravel.com, and here there is a documentation. And into the documentation, there is the installation and the server requirements. So into the server requirements here, you can see there is actually the required for the 7.1 or the equal. So right now I am my localhost server at PHP version in 1x1 with you. So before installing the Laravel, we need to update our PHP version. So how can do that work? I will show you. For doing this, first of all, you have to go this website, that is sourceforkey.net, and then the project, and then the Xampp. And into this position, they have option for the files. Like here, there is actually the option for the files. Right now, I'm click on here. And into the files, there are so many options like Xampp for the OS, Xampp for the Linux, and Xampp for the Windows. So right now, I'm using the Windows. For right now, I just click on here. And into the Windows here, you can see that is all the Xampp version, like 7.3 version, that is actually the latest version, and that is the 7.2, that is the 7.1, then 7.3, that is 7.2. So whatever the things you want to download, you can download that things from here. So right now, like if you want to download the 7.1 now, just click on here. And into this position, like there is actually the Xampp portable Windows for the 64-bit, and there is actually another GIF file. And also there is a Xampp Windows for the 64-bit 7.13. And that is also, there is another one. And that is also another Xampp and Windows 64. There is also another GIF file. And this GIF file actually, there is actually 209 megabyte one of the file. So if you want to download it, just simply click on here. Then it should be automatically download in your computer. So first of all, you have to download it. Like I already download that things like in your exercise file. So that is actually the folder. I will share that folder with you. So you will get that exercise file, and into the exercise file, like I already download one of the PHP version as a 7.0, but it's okay with me. So whatever you want, you can download that things from here. That is all that version. Okay. So right now I'm already downloaded. And first of all, you have to do that. You can see that is actually the GIF file. So first of all, you have to just click on here and click on the extract here. So after extract here, then you get this type of folder. That is actually the Xampp folder. And into the Xampp folder, they have so many files on particular disposition. Okay. So first of all, here we have to do, we have to actually update the Apache, we have to update the PHP, and then that is the PHP by admin. So these three folder I have to update in our local host. So when you install the Xampp, like when you install the Xampp, you will get one of the folder. Like if you go to your computer, like here I am actually installing it on our C drive. So into the C drive, when you install the Xampp, you get this type of folder in your C drive, that is actually the Xampp folder. So into the Xampp folder, there is also another, you can see there is a Apache, there is a PHP, and there is a PHP by admin. So these three files, I just want to update it. Okay, so right now I'm using as a 5.4. So I just want to update it. Okay, so for doing this, first of all, you have to do, you have to actually stop your Apache and the MySQL. So here I just stop the Apache and stop the MySQL. And now you can delete that all that file from here. Better I just make that as a rename. Okay, then it should be better. I just make the things as a, like as a old. Okay, so here I just make the things as a old, that is a PHP. So I also want to update that file, so I also make that as a old. And also I have to update this one, that is PHP by admin. So here I also assign as a old. So now I have to do, I have to update three of these folders. So I, in our local host, like here in our exercise file, there is our Xampp. Okay. So right now in our Xampp, like there is actually our exercise file from this position. I just copy the Apache folder, PHP folder, and PHP by admin. So I just simply copy it. So here I just copy three of this folder, and in our local host, that means in our C drive, there is a Xampp. Here I already renamed all that our previous file, and now here I just simply paste it. Like here I just paste three of this folder. So it may take little time, so you have to wait little bit for it. So now here I paste three of this folder as Apache, and then the PHP, and the PHP my admin. Okay, so I hope you can well understand about it. And then you have to do, you have to go to the PHP folder, and here they have one of the file as a, that is actually the php.init. Okay, so first of all, here I just open with the sublink text editor, and into this position I just click on the control F, and here I just search as a Xampp. And into this position, you have to actually update this path. Okay, so right now I am actually installing it on our C drive. So here, if you go to these positions, like that is the things you have to update. So here I just copy it, and now in our Xampp here I have to update this path. So here I just paste it. Okay, and now click on the find next. So this one I also have to update this path. So there is another one, so I have to update it. So here I just simply update, and then this path. So here I also updated that things, and now this one I update it. Okay, and this one, and this one here I just update it, and also another one. There is another one. So here I just update our all that path, and if you go here, perfect. Okay, so now you have to do, you have to actually save it. So here I just save that file, and then you have to do, you have to start your Apache again. Like here I just start this Apache again and start the MySQL again. Okay, and now if you go to this position, and right now I just want to search it again as a local host. Now if you go to the PHP info, yeah. Yes, now you can see now our PHP version is now updated. That is a 7.0. So right now I am using as a 7.0. So whatever you want, you can upload that things from here. So that is actually the file. So you have to actually download that zip file. You have to extract it. So for education purpose, I am using as a 7.0 is okay with me. And this file, I will share that things with you in your exercise file. So this folder, I will share with you. Okay. So that is the zip file. First of all, you have to extract it. And then you have to actually update this three folder. There is an Apache folder, there is a PHP folder, and the PHP MyAdmin. And after pasting that, you have to update this path. So here I also update this path. And now it's perfectly updated. So if you now access the PHP MyAdmin, like if you click on here, yes, perfect. Now you can see I can also access the PHP MyAdmin. So that's all the database related, all the issues. We will do that work on particular this position. So step by step, I will show you each and everything with live example. So before installing the Laravel, we need that requirement things. Okay, so for the reasons I just updated our local host. So in our next video, I will show you how can install that Laravel in your local host. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.